10.
Wind carry you, Aloy.
Aloy, you've returned. I hear you've been making quite the impression on the clan lands. Saving the desert clan from itself, forcing the commander Tecote out of hiding, defending the grove from Regala, and ending her rebellion on the wings of the Ten.
I didn't do it alone.
The humble words of a true warrior.
Your sister sent me. Her squad's been assigned further west, so she won't be able to come see you, Corey. She wanted to make sure you knew.
That sounds like my sister.
Is something wrong?
No. Yes. There's a song I want to play, one of my own making, but it's hopeless. I'm just never going to get the sound right.
What makes you say that?
Back in the clan lands, the Sky Clan built instruments that cast sound to sky and across the mountains. They use long-legged throats to make them bellow with the sound of metal. It's how they communicate between villages. Combining that sound with the Utaru's would create a melody unlike anyone's ever heard before. But I won't be hunting for any long legs anytime soon.
For now, you should try the Metal Weaver again. They might have some new piece you can use.
Right.
This song means a lot to him, doesn't it?
It does, which is why I'm getting him that machine part. It'll be a surprise. The Utaru say that's the best way to receive a gift.
Is there a long leg around here?
As it happens, one has been troubling some villages southwest of here. You be doing me and Plainsong a favor by getting rid of it. Interested?
Maybe. If I make my way down there, I'd like to help.
I appreciate that. I'll head southwest and see if I can pick up a trail.
Stop pouring out of the cave after Zoe and her companions went inside. It's been a while.
Jax is in trouble. Use the backup. You okay?
You arrived not a moment too soon, Huntress. I thought I heard a long legs call, so I hastened to follow, but I was caught unaware by these machines instead. There it is again.
Let's go find it. Sounds like our long legs at the top of that cliff. Well, looks like we're climbing.
We'll make quick work of it. This reminds me of my early days as a veteran. Always running off to hunt in the wilds. As far away from plain song as possible.
What changed?
I saw my first Yutaru students become fighters worthy of any Tanakh clan. I felt useful, like I belonged. And so plain song became home.
I'm sure Corey will find his place too.
I hope so.
Almost there. Oh, it sounds like that lone leg is alone up there.
And the Yutaru have fell. Might be best to silence it before it can call reinforcements.
Plasma will make quick work of it.
Machines incoming. Now we salvage the part we came for. Where are you off to? Care to show me our prize, Hunter? Hey, Lord, a word before we go. Hey. One last thing, Huntress. Care to show me our prize, Huntress? Many thanks, Aloy. Without you, I might have been in trouble. Why don't you take that piece to Corey for me? The villagers failed by these machines need to have their seeds buried properly first.
Are you sure?
Tell Corey I better be the first to hear that song of his when I return.
Corey.
Aloy? I thought you had left Plainsong.
Well, I thought about it, but then I'd have to carry this long leg throat all by myself.
You found?
Jax did.
That old man.
Can still hear perfectly fine. So let's hear it.
I'm gonna need some help. Aloy, can you take this to the workbench, please? You won't have to do much, I promise. You'll see a wide cavity on the instrument. That piece should fit right in.
May the wind carry you.
If you want to improve your next hunt, let's trade.
Let us see your handiwork. Aloy, come show us the instrument. Corey would love to see the instrument you crafted.
I think it's good to go.
song of two peoples indeed.
Thank you, Aloy. My debt to you seems to only grow.
Hearing that was payment enough.
That may be, but you should at least take this. You deserve it.
May the wings of the Ten hearten your step.